Most of the cells in our body are covered with proteins called human leukocyte antigens, or HLAs. HLAs serve as tiny identification tags, telling the immune system that a cell is healthy and not infected with a virus or damaged in some way. That's important, because when intruders like bacteria or viruses enter our body, HLAs help alert the immune system to their presence. When a virus or bacterium infects a cell, the cell's HLAs display pieces of the invader. The immune system notices them and launches an attack on the invaders, but leaves healthy cells alone. HLAs also play an important role in donor stem cell transplants, also known as allogeneic transplants. Stem cell transplants are a powerful way to treat cancers of the blood, like leukemia. During a transplant, patients receive an infusion of cells, known as hematopoietic stem cells. These generate all the cells found in blood, red cells, white cells, and platelets. If the transplanted stem cells come from a donor, they carry the donor's HLAs. When the donor's HLAs are identical to the patient's own, they are generally accepted by the patient without triggering a harmful immune system attack. If there is too great a mismatch between the HLAs of the donor and the patient, the transplanted stem cells might launch an attack on the patient's normal healthy tissue. This can lead to a potentially dangerous condition called graft versus host disease, or GVHD. Today, advances make it possible to perform successful transplants when donors and patients are partial HLA matches. Around the world, hundreds of thousands of people have had their HLA type determined and stored in registries. That way, when a patient needs a stem cell donor, a compatible one can often be quickly identified. Many times, the closest matches are between patients and donors of similar ethnic backgrounds. That's why it's important for as many people as possible to be HLA typed and to register as potential donors. The discovery of HLAs and their role in helping our body fight off disease has led to treatments that have helped thousands of people live longer, and in many cases, be cured of cancer.